who is a principal, but we never felt that madam is always saying that I am a principal. In fact, whenever we meet her, she try to make us that we are like and she's like us only. Thank you madam for that. You are always a welcoming gesture which you showed to your students, to your colleagues, to your friends. Thank you ma'am. Amita madam, over to you. Hello.
Yeah. Okay. There's a lot of work going around, so some sort of disturbance is there, but hope that you won't mind it. Today we require this motivational talk. We are in dire necessity. It was, of course, suggested by our principal, very beloved principal, Dr. Himanshu Davada, that let us inspire students since they have a certain gap of nearly starting the next year, academic year. We have nearly 25 to, you know, almost a month later that they are going to start, or 25 days. So it is very essential that we motivate our student to not to lapse into any kind of depression, any kind of untoward mental, you know, activity they involve in. Let us not get into negative realm. And it is important that we pull out ourselves towards positivity, sunshine, and a lot of breathing space, especially that is required in today's time for our, you know, pandemic times. It is very crucial. All over the world, people are going through this kind of depression. So, sir suggested that we, every department, that we keep a motivational lecture so that we keep our morale high, and at the same time see to it that we remain in that sphere of positivity. Therefore, we have invited the most eminent and quite a stalwart in this area, Dr. Suchitra Nayak, principal of Joshi Bedekar College. There is a lot to say, but she has given a very short. I have taken from, in fact.
No, madam, that's enough. We will proceed. Really not required. Really not.
No.
I'm a teacher and I'm a student.
Yeah, that is always there. But I would just like to go through in only 2 minutes. Give me only 2 minutes, okay? Thank you, ma'am. So, madam is MA, PhD, PG diploma in counseling and child guidance. Madam is principal of Joshi Bedekar College, Thane, and head department of philosophy. Madam has completed PhD thesis titled Philosophy of Education, Reconstructive Analysis and Evaluation of Aims, Methods and Constructs. Madam has worked as a full-time counselor in college, completed minor research on helping suicidal teenagers, appointed as a committee member in Marathi Mandal, published and presented papers in a few state-level, national and international-level journals and seminars, worked as a consultant for neighboring Polytechnic College and Kendriya Vidyalay, Navi Camp, Karanja and IIT Powai, as a counselor. Guided the above institutions to initiate counseling centers and counseling programs for teachers and students. Invited as a resource person at UGC Human Resource Development Center, University of Mumbai, to conduct a session during orientation course of degree college teachers. The theme of the session was counseling, teaching and mentoring, contours and convergence. The core activities of madam is main is counseling cell that they have. So it is core activity conducted by her under the leadership, naturally her leadership. It comprises of providing personal counseling to more than madam is already personally counseled, more than 1,000 students. Conducted activities for junior college students and their parents, de-addiction initiative for students, employability initiative for students, outreaching activities in the rural areas, visiting to, excuse me my pronunciation, Mokhada Hirave village as a part of a memorandum of understanding with Parivartan Mahila Sanstha, workshop for local teachers and volunteers of Mokhada Hirave village, counseling for students of Northeast Meghalaya, designed programs to create barefoot counselors among students, conducted various social activities under the aegis of Manthan, like lectures, film shows, talk shows, etc. We welcome Dr. Suchitra Nayak to deliver her talk on this very, very pivotal topic. Thank you, ma'am. Please welcome.
At the very outset, I thank Amit Madam, and I am humbled by your introduction. As I feel, I believe that I am a very simple person, and I want to continue to be like that. First of all, I would like you to convey my regards to Principal Dr. Davra and also Director Dr. Usha Mukundan, who is torchbearer as far as higher education is concerned. So I also thank you for giving me this opportunity, because human mind is such that it needs reminders again and again. So, when you have to talk about hope, when you have to talk about positivity, actually, you are also reminding everything to yourselves. There are certain esteemed colleagues, revered colleagues. Sheshadri sir is here, Geeta madam is here. Of course, Amita madam and Reena madam, they are very close friends of mine. They have been very close to Joshi Bedekar College. Our association is very long. Also, some of my college colleagues are here. And one of my esteemed colleagues, she has sent me the video. I couldn't download it due to technical problems on the title, We Shall Overcome. So thank you, madam, for that. And though there are very few students, I would like to greet them all. So a warm good morning to all the students who are present over here. Okay. And thank you very much for this opportunity. I request Amita madam to start the PPT.
Yes.
So
okay. Sure.
Okay. So next one, please. Yes. So madam has talked so much about counseling. All students know, all my colleagues know, it's working for a better today and better tomorrow. Many times people think that only when we have some problems, some distress, then alone we are supposed to see a counselor. No, it's not like that. See, we all are living, and there can be different directions of living. There can be better ways of living. So sometimes we need to think about them. Sometimes, the situation is such that it imposes us to think about what can be different ways of living, what can be the better ways of living. And when we take up this new journey to explore the new ways, okay, we need somebody as a mentor, we need somebody as a friend, we need somebody as a confederate, and precisely this work is done by a counselor. Okay, so counseling is not only for problems and worries and so-called mental disorders. It's for all of us, okay? As in psychology, it is always said, who is a normal person? A normal person is one who some or the other time behaves abnormally, okay? So we all have ups and downs. We all have pitfalls in our lives. We all tend to face stress. We all tend to be depressed at some or the other time. So it's a tight rope walk. Life is like a tight rope walk. Okay. So counseling helps us to maintain our balance in this journey of life. Okay. So next one, please. Now, as I said, let us start with some
activity, because when we are virtually together, sometimes it becomes claustrophobic. Okay, so let us start with a simple activity. What is this activity, especially if students, for a while, if you can, if I can see at least one or two of you, I'll enjoy this activity because I will also be doing it with you. So, you know, what we have to do is just clap. Okay, but it's not just usual clap. We will try to create a sound for ourselves. We will try to do it differently. It's very simple activity. It's very usual activity, but let us try and do it very differently. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to hold hand like this. Serena madam, I'll request you, or whom I can see, any one of the students. Yes, okay, so students can also do the same. It's my request, appeal to all the students, youngsters, and teachers, everybody, let us be together and let us do something together. Okay, so this activity is as simple as this, and afterwards I'll be asking you a question. So how what you could hear when you were doing this activity. So how we have to clap, we have to hold one hand like this and clap with one finger, just your small finger. Yes, go on clapping. One finger. Okay, now two fingers, now three fingers, now four fingers. Loud. Yes. Now again, three fingers. Now two fingers. Now one finger. Yes. Now you can clap your huge. Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much for participating, Reena madam. Yes. So have you felt when we were listening to this simple clap? Was it a usual sound, or it reminded you of something? Because it has got a specific name. And when we all do it together, we can hear that. So can anybody tell me how it sounded when, sound slowly withering away and sound again becoming stronger? Yes, I can see Bhavika. Yes, Bhavika, would you like to answer?
Ma'am, like rain.
Exactly. Precisely, these claps are called as rain claps. Amita madam, you are going to give a chocolate to Bhavika on my behalf. Okay. Yes, Bhavika, thank you so much.
Definitely, so Bhavika.
Yeah, it we could hear the rains. Okay, so I just wanted to give you the feel of that. Now, I would like to ask you a question. Madam has given a kind of prelude to this activity, to this lecture. See, on what background we all are living today? What is the backdrop of this, world drama? What is the backdrop? The situation in which we are today. What is the most dominant thing?
Students, please participate.
Yes, please feel free to talk. Then alone you can enjoy it. Okay, please feel. Everybody who is willing.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Financial status of people is changing, and that is leading them into a lot of emotional and mental trauma.
Okay, but why suddenly this financial state is changing? I can see answer in chat.
Ma'am,
also.
Depend.
Exactly. So anxiety is there. Yes, anxiety-driven life is there, and anxiety is about what? It's about the pandemic. Okay, it's about the suffering. It's about. And what is that number one enemy today, which has almost, taken over our entire public sphere, our private space, our mental space? It has occupied everything. What is that one word? What is the name? What has caused the pandemic? Yes, family existence. Yes, yes, very true. But what is that thing? What is the pandemic? Yeah, yes, Pradnya madam. Oh, yes, Pradnya, thank you. It's COVID-19 or Corona. Okay, now everybody, you switch on the television, everybody's talking COVID, everybody's talking Corona, everybody's talking only pandemic, you know, everywhere. It's not media, it's your workplace, it's in the house, you know, your relatives, it is there. I don't say it is not there. Okay, Pradnya, yes. You will be madam very soon. So it's your relatives, your friends, you know, who are far off or maybe who stay near you. You can hear about deaths. You can hear about suffering. Yes, it is the difficult situation. You can hear about, as somebody pointed it out, you know, very deteriorating financial conditions. You know, it's everything going haywire. Okay, so we can hear all this thing. We are also talking that continuously, and when we speak a word, try to understand, that is percolating in your unconscious mind. I won't go into the theory of conscious and unconscious because we don't have that much of time now, but whatever we speak, somewhere, first of all, it affects our own mind. Okay, so somebody is scared, I am scared. Someone else is scared, this has happened, I am scared. So everywhere, you know, we are reassuring one condition. Just I would like to make a passing reference. People earlier years were talking about catharsis. Ki chalo bolenge to wo chala jayega. But you know, today people don't believe in catharsis hypothesis. They say that our brain is such a machine that you put a word, you know, that is rehearsed. Okay, so once you talk your worries, once you talk your things, you are away from it. Okay, you are done with that. But if you are talking same thing again and again, what your brain is doing, it is rehearsing that word. And you know, the boomerang law, which is there in universe, applies to our mind also. So what comes back to you is nervousness, anxiety, and fear and sorrow. Everything comes back to us. Okay, so here Pradnya, I can see Bhavika. The next activity, next slide please. The next activity, purposely I have so we all know it. See, with all respect to, I mean, the life situation through which we are going, but I want you to say something about your any experience, okay, without using the word pandemic, fear, trauma, and anxiety, stress, distress, Corona, COVID. Leave aside these words, okay? So can describe any such experience, maybe in two sentences, maybe in four or five sentences. I'll be very happy. I'll be very happy if anybody wants to participate in this very simple exercise, okay? So you'll have to think, okay, what experience I had in, you know, earlier, I mean, in these days, which I can describe without making reference to Corona or without making reference to pandemic. Definitely, we are having so many experiences. Even if we are at home, there are so many experiences. Yes, Shailendra. Yes, I would. Shailendra wants to talk.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Time बहुत है हमारे पास.
Time?
बहुत है हमारे पास. ऐसा पता चला कि busy life नहीं है अभी.
Yes. So you're happy that you have got lot of time. Yes, very good, Shailendra. I'm happy you have pointed out at something, a very, very advantageous thing, because we are always running against time. Either pahunchna hai, udhar jana hai, train lena hai, taxi lena hai, what
not. Online classes.
online classes. Okay, yes, so you are saving traveling. I could see one chat, but I couldn't read that. I'll just read that. Yes. Okay. Yeah, tell me. Anything else?
Professor Pramod Kumar Dash says fear of tomorrow.
But I want you to say something positive, which we are experiencing. As Shailendra said, yes, nowadays we have time at our disposal. Fear of tomorrow is something. Will this situation change? Okay. More time with family. Yes, Deepak, very happy about this reaction. More time with our family. Okay, we are blessed that family's health is very good. Pradnya, I'm so happy. Yes. So we have started seeing various blessings in the same situation. Same pandemic is there. But now slowly and gradually, when we have changed the direction of our thinking, you know, blessings of the situation have started. Can focus on our hobbies. Very good, Deepak again. Rina Madam is saying nothing is permanent. Yes, we are experiencing that, actually experiencing the things which we take for granted. We cannot always take them for granted. Yes, Shishadri sir, everything transforms over time. We need to look forward with patience. Yes, sir, that is what we have learned from you always. Yes, Bhavika, Neha, I don't want to read that word. Okay, without that word, time is unpredictable. Yes, it's a lesson for all of us. Time is unpredictable. Yes, so hobbies. Somebody has written about hobbies. Somebody can spend just one hobby which you could pursue during this time. Just one hobby which you could give time to. Yes, discovered the lost chef in me. Very good, Deepak. Started painting. Yes, very good. I'm so happy. Yes. So, see, when we say that the situation is bad. Yes, cook. Yes, madam. Yes, yogic exercise. Yes, very good. So, you know, situation is a situation. What we talk about it, how we react to it is our choice. I mean, I just wanted to give this realization to students, especially Mehndi. Yes, so many things are coming up. Okay. And but what is happening? Television is talking, you know, it's banging on us the same word, the same tragedies. I don't say they are not there. But if we want to remain healthy, hell and hearty, we need to see other things as well. Next, please. I hope, madam, I have time. Rina, madam, Amita, madam.
Please feel free.
Yes,
madam.
From whatever reactions I have gathered now, right from Shailendra, Deepak, and some teachers also, I'm sure, Shishadri sir, okay? Yes, music sessions of an Antakshari, fantastic, sir. I would like to listen to that. So, in a way, you know, the young generation, I am saying here as your little older friend, that you have got this opportunity to see life, to see other side of the life. No, otherwise we all were saying the life is caught up today in malls, in enjoyment, in PUBG, and in drugs, and so on and so forth. So youngsters are now seeing totally different side. I mean, we all, but it is a direct opportunity for youngsters. So I think life is about what? Life is about changing. Yes, free fire. Yeah, okay. So life is about, you know, changing challenges into opportunities. We all know it. We all read all inspirational talks. What's a यूनिवर्सिटी nowadays it is called. What's up university? तो इतना ज्ञान बांटती है सुबह सुबह, you know, all good morning messages. Life is about this, life is about that. So yes, this may appear to be very common sentence, okay? But see, the thing is, yes, we all know life is about changing challenge into opportunities. Our concern is when this opportunity comes, how we are supposed to do it. Okay, now see, the simple answer is, if you want to see the opportunity, you have to start now. And where? Here. Okay, so here and now is the answer to give a kind of to infuse our life with positivity. Okay, next please. So again, next slide please. Again, this is a very famous statement, you know, about pessimist and optimist. Psychology students, you must have heard this example also. If there are two people sitting with glasses of water half filled, okay, the optimist will say, oh, I'm so lucky, my glass is half full. And the pessimist will say, oh, I'm so unlucky, my glass is half empty. Now, nowadays, you know, people go on adding to it an opportunist. And actually, once I had received this answer from one of my students who said, madam, my glass is not empty at all. Half of the glass is full of water and half of the glass is full of air. Okay, so I was very happy to listen to that maybe 10 years back. Okay, so it all depends upon how you look at it. Huh? So we need to change difficulties into new opportunities, and we need to take up challenges and go ahead. Now, see here, I have tried to just suggest a few ways in which we can do that. Okay, yes, a pessimist feels hopeless and hence feels very helpless. But can we afford to feel helpless? That is what I want to say. Okay, next one please. Okay, so next slide. Yes, so it is all about the activity which we have taken just now is all about what, you know, is all about our perception. See, we can see, can students help me again? So we can feel that, yes, we all are actively over here. So what you can see in this image? Yes, Bhavika or Shailendra or Deepak can, yes, optimism is full of hope. And yes, labor and seeing opportunity. Yes, sir. So yes, Shailendra, what you can see in this image?
Ma'am, second wale mein women dikh rahe do, par first wala nahi tha.
Yeah. So two faces facing each other. Only this much you can see. If you will focus on the white area, what you are able to see? Just focus on white area. Yes, a vase. Yes, very correct. So is it a vase or it's a profile of two people? I mean, one who sees the vase, it is vase for that person. But yes, one who sees the faces, it is their faces. Here also, you can see a person blowing a trumpet in the first one. And also, beautiful face of a beautiful young lady. So how you see, it's about life. Let me tell you what you see here, how you see here. You know, that day I get very little time to watch television, but watching news is very necessary. So, you know, the thing is, in one of the hospitals, since the drop rate is quite good now, you know, there are no new cases. So, four or five young doctors, ladies, you know, they were making a circle and dancing. And I said, oh, this frontline warriors have every right to do that. Okay. Still, there were patients in their hospital. Still, you know, the medical services they were giving. But all these days, There was no day and night. They were working continuously. So now they got a time to breathe and they felt like rejoicing about it. I need to rejoice. Yes, I'm here. Yes, I'm able. I have my near and dear ones over here. We need to see the blessings in whatever. I mean, I know the damage is big, but still there are certain blessings. So what we focus on, the white part, the black part, the two faces or vase or, young lady or a person blowing trumpet, it's all up to us. Situation is a situation. It's like, to speak philosophy, it is Brahman. It is just existing. How we see it is our perception. Next, please. So life is about that. I always admire, there are so many therapies. In fact, in psychology, the psychology world is crowded with therapies, and people ultimately talk about eclectic counseling, that is combination of many things. But I think this person stands apart as far as therapy is concerned, as far as human well-being is concerned. Okay, why? He's a psychiatrist who has survived Hitler's concentration camp. Now, see, we should read his book. It's my appeal to all of you, students, to read his book, Meaning in Life, or in the Pursuit of Meaning of Life. I'll convey the exact title, or you can get it on Google as well. Okay. See, wherein, he has described also his situation in concentration camp, where he was thrown in one camp, or he was, yes, man's search for meaning. Thank you very much, Neha. So he was thrown in one camp. He lost his wife and his young daughter because they were thrown somewhere else. And ultimately, they died also. And you simply can't read the pathetic situation in which Viktor Frankl and thousands of people like him, who were very respected members of society, they were just thrown. We can't read that. It is so bad. Okay, and then he takes a dialogue with himself. Okay, he talks to himself, saying that if do something about this situation. In our next slides, we are going to have this reference again. But I thought earlier. Yes. So so what can I do? Okay, what I can do? And here, this, I think this very, very, I feel it's a golden sentence, or whatever we may say. The forces beyond your control can take away everything you possess. Okay, and it meant, literally this was true about Viktor Frankl, let me tell you, including clothes, which symbolize our dignity, including that, everything was taken away from them. Leave aside their houses, leave aside money, leave aside anything and everything. Everything was taken away from these people, and they all were learned teachers, learned, doctors, social workers, so on, scientists. Okay, everybody was there, and they were treated, even, their dignity was taken away from them. So everything can be taken away from you, what you possess, except one thing. That is your freedom to choose how you will respond to that particular situation. Nobody can take away your freedom. I think I'm not going into jargon of philosophy, but entire existentialist philosophy, Amit Madam knows it better. So many films have depicted this theme, but besides, this freedom, nobody can take away from you. Okay? And we have to bag on this freedom on this response to a situation. The words, each and every word is chosen, or it's you know, arka jisko bolte hai na Marathi madhe hamanto arka hai, you know, it's an essence of his experience, what he has undergone. So how I will respond, he's not saying how I'll react. Okay, our reactions are, oh, most of the times very, very sentimental and emotional. Okay, so he's not talking of reactions. He to talk in terms of emotional intelligence, the amygdala, you know, the master brain or the part of brain which controls our emotions. So, you know, he's saying, I'm not saying reactions, he's using the word respond. How do I respond to my fear? How do I respond to my fear of tomorrow? How do I respond to recession of my financial funds and situation? How do I respond? This is $1 million word. My response, which has to come from reason, doesn't mean emotions have no role to play. No, not at all. Emotions are very, very, very important in life. Okay, but how we blend emotion and reason is most important. So what Viktor Frankl did, he said that I will surpass the situation and purpose by the purpose of my life and hope now to take the world what we have got and how.
I think it is disconnected. We will wait for 2 minutes. Madam will join soon. It is disconnected. Yes. Yeah, madam has got disconnected. Just waiting, madam, to come back.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Yeah,
yes,
I'll continue.
Yes.
Yes, I'll continue.
Yeah, continue, please.
So, yes, so it was for Viktor Frankl. It was a very reasoned decision. Okay, see, in human life, every now and then we need to make decisions, and these decisions depend upon our how we think and how we feel. Okay, both the things are equally important. Okay, now see, the situation in which we are. Okay, you all have made very positive decisions of learning something, of spending time with your friends and your family. So this is the reasoned response you need to give. Okay, people have seen opportunity in this. Okay, new business spills have come up as old one have gone. Okay, so there are, I know two young girls who have started making scented sanitizers. Okay, pharma girls, students. Okay, so you know, people have started seeing opportunities. So it all depends upon what decision I make to form my attitude towards life, that is towards whatever situation we are undergoing through, and also to what emotions I nurture. Okay, now Lao Tzu, once it was he was telling a young boy, of course it is a symbolic story, that there are two wolves in our mind. One is positive and the other is negative. The small child asks him, which one is stronger? And the answer, prompt answer is, of course, the one you nurture, okay? So negativity and positivity, they're our parts only. And which one we nurture by putting which words in our mind, that matters a lot. Let me tell you, the entire therapy of NLP, neuro-linguistic programming, is about how we talk to ourselves, what words we use when we are talking to ourselves. Okay, next one. So see what your emotions are, see how you are going to respond towards them, and we need to somehow jump to positivity. Okay, it's a leap. And I think Amit Madam will definitely agree with me. You know, it is the leap which true religion has talked about. It is the leap of faith. It is the leap, you know. I don't remember exactly the song, but somewhere it says, you know, it's a Sufi song, I'm in the ocean, huh? Darya mein hai, okay? Agar kinare ko jayenge, to sahil bhi tu hai. That is God or the divinity. Sahil bhi tu hai. Doob gaye to darya bhi tu hi hai. So I am in safe hands. I am in the hands of divinity. Okay? Ye jo faith hai. You know, faith is not given. Okay? It's not given. We have to form the habit of jumping to positivity again and again in all our small and big, big situations. I'll just give you one example, very famous example. See, there were twins. I always quote this example, but I always feel there is so much to learn from this example. There are twins born to a schizophrenic mother. Okay, twins born to a schizophrenic mother. This is written by, I'll tell you that afterwards. And you know, the mother is so violent. The mother is so full of, frenzy attacks. She's ill, mentally ill, basically. And every day she's telling her children, aap kya karoge? See, I'm mad. And your mother being mad, you will also be the same in future, and you will end up your life in mental asylum. Always, every day. Main pagal hu, aap dono bhi pagal hi hoge, and you will end up your life in mental asylum. They have virtually grown hearing this sentence. Virtually grown. I mean, you can imagine. Huh? So it's not only external situations. I mean, when I meet my client friends, okay, I feel, you know, everybody's struggle is different, everybody's challenges are different, okay? So, you know, they grow up, and you know, as their mother has cursed them, they actually end up their life in mental asylum, okay? With the only difference, identical twins, huh? With the only difference, one person becomes schizophrenic, lunatic, and the other brother becomes the dean of the mental asylum. So that is jumping to positivity. He says, okay, I'll be in mental asylum, but not as a patient, I'll be the director over there. So, you know, situations are difficult. Human life is not easy at all. It's not about, you know, easy going, okay? God or divinity or nature wants us to be very strong, very tenacious, very, you know, having inner strength. And that is why all these difficulties are thrown to us. Okay. So life is about jumping to positivity, which Viktor Frankl did. His videos are available on net. You can just listen to him. It's an experience in itself when we read his books. Okay. Next one, please. So our challenge is to jump into this positivity and keep on telling us ki ye waqt bhi guzar jayega, sunahara kal fir se aayega, khushiyan degi fir se dastak, sab kehte tek prabhu ke mastak, समय दुविधा हर हार जाएगा, सीख बहुत कुछ दे जाएगा. You shouldn't ignore this, the learning which is taking place. Okay, now perhaps which educational institutions couldn't do, children and youngsters and we all are learning very different lessons of our life. Okay, sooja boojh se hai ladna aur niyam se hai chalna, desh mera fir abad hoga. It's so old poem but it is so relevant. Desh mera fir abad hoga, sankat ko to talna hai, talna hoga, kyunki ye waqt bhi guzar jayega, sunahra kal fir aayega. Prabhu ki leela prabhu hi jante hai, chheena hai sab kuch usne kisi na kisi bahane, वो लौटाना भी जानता है. ओके, अवर यू नो फ्री मोमेंट्स विद फ्रेंड्स. आई कम टू कॉलेज ऑलमोस्ट एवरी डे. यू नो आई एम मिसिंग माय स्टूडेंट्स सो मच सो दैट नाउ आई हैव स्टार्टेड ड्रीमिंग दैट ऑल क्लासेस आर फुल. आई एम यू नो टॉकिंग टू स्टूडेंट्स सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ, बट द थिंग्स हैव चेंज्ड सो मच. आई हैव स्कोल्डेड सो मेनी ऑफ माय स्टूडेंट्स फॉर you know watching mobiles, and nowadays I scold them if they are not on mobile when lecture is there. Okay, so these contradictions are also there. Okay, prabhu ki leela prabhu hi jante hai, chheena hai sab kuch usne kisi na kisi bahane, wo lautana bhi jante hai isliye ye waqt bhi guzar jayega, sunahra kal fir se aayega. Okay, yeah. So yes, so for this, what is most important, two things are very, very important, which seem very different. You know, people say, you know, when they want to have a session on counseling, they tell me, madam, either you can talk on emotional management or you talk on time management. Okay, I said, but they are same. Time given to all of us is same. You know, we are not able to manage that because we are not able to manage our emotions. Nowadays, you know, the new generation with new challenges, I can see, you know, they're so hooked to games, you know, games on internet, PUBG, and you know, so many games are, they're into gaming. It is a career also, but it's not career for all. They're getting hooked to it very badly. They are getting hooked to it, so they are wasting so much of time on that. Okay, and here they are not able to do time management. Why? Because that temptation they are not able to manage. Okay, as Oscar Wilde said, I can resist anything but temptation. Okay, it's difficult to manage temptation. So, you know, we need to evolve emotionally. We need to understand, first of all, never deny our emotions. Understand our emotions. Put a simple label to them. It's okay. Okay, and once we are okay with our emotions, maybe we can use our time more constructively. Okay, so if we want to make wise decisions, if we want to respond to our situation, what is most important, most basic, is evolve our emotions. You see, these are, you can see the faces. If I would like to hear once again from my student friends what all emotions you are able to see over here.
I'm crying.
Yes, what emotions? Can you see the six faces? Yes, Bhavika was answering. Who was answering? Yes. Yes, crying. Okay. Yes, one face is crying. That is sorrow. Yes. Anything else? First is sorrow. Yes, it's an emotion of sorrow. Second is what?
Shocked.
Shocked or surprised. Yes. Third is what? What is the emotion?
Smiling.
Yes, yes, smiling. That is, we are happy. Yes, very good. Somebody is happy over here. Next is?
Disgust.
Yes, yes. yes, it is crown or you know, yes, crownful or disgust. Okay, this one. Yes, anger, and last one. Yes, Prachali madam. Yeah, fear, shocked, scared. Okay, now for students, my appeal is make these faces at your home. You can actually create them. Yes, shocked. Yes, you can create them at home, wear them. See, many a times we don't even know what emotions we are having. Leave aside, you know, their acceptance. We don't know. We are babies sometimes, you know, as far as emotions are concerned. Okay, we are feeling something and we say something else. Okay, so to understand, to know our emotions, to understand them, to express them properly, as Aristotle had said about anger, you know, to be angry at the right point of time with the right person, with right intention. Okay, with right intensity and with right expression is a skill. This is what Aristotle said. So what are my emotions? I ask very simple question to in the class, you know, generally when I'm talking about emotions. See, if you have taught your friend who is not very regular in class because of her or his some difficulties, okay, or whatever, okay. Now you stand second in the class and your friend comes first. What will be your emotions? Okay, so post this type of exercises, Reena madam, I'll say we can have such puzzles. They are very simple, but they help us to understand our own self. Okay, I don't want any ready answer because there cannot be any goody-goody answer. Oh, I'll feel very happy because my friend has come first. No, they are not all that simple. At the same time, it's not that, hey, I'm feeling very jealous. No, it's not that also. Something mixture of the two. Okay, anyways, so it is very, very, very important to understand emotions. And some other time we will talk about, you know, how to evolve. Now, I feel, Amit madam, I mean, all my veteran philosophy people are here. Just earlier slide, just 1 second, just one comment I would like to make. This evolving emotions, entire virtue ethics is about this. How we can evolve our emotions and how we can, to talk in Freudian paradigm, how we can sublimate our emotions. Next slide, please. And once we master this, then mastering time is not difficult. I think somebody said, Deepak said, or who said, Shailendra? Somebody said we have
Deepak, so Pujari, much Deepak Pujari's professor, Deepak Pujari.
Okay, sorry.
No. Please. But I told you that we are all students, so no problem. He was our student, but now teaching zoology.
Okay. So now we are seeing other side of time management. Okay, now there was no time.
This meeting is being recorded.
Okay. So there was no time in earlier days maybe, and now we have plenty of time. In either situation, we need to manage it. And how we can manage it? By doing perfect management of our emotions. Study, I want to study. Bas ek 10 minute WhatsApp pe, then I'll study. Bas ek ghanta Insta pe, I'll read just 10 stories on Insta and then I'll turn to studies. Aisa nahi hota. You know, we need to have perfect timetable, and perfect timetable can be executed with perfect emotional understanding. Next, please. Next. Yes. Yeah, so we need to look within ourselves. Somebody talked here about financial crunch, and the financial distress. Yes, it is there. But I told you about these two girls, pharma students, who opened a small factory of scented sanitizers. Okay, so many a times, I don't say always, but many a times, problems are solutions in disguise. We need to think out of the box. We need to think besides our fears. Okay, you know that famous statement, all students know it very well, you know, Mountain Dew advertisement, Dar ke aage jeet hai. Okay, so we have to execute that in our lives. If we think differently, we can hit upon the solutions. Next, please. Yes, so we need to get the grip of the cake or the bread, which is there in front of us today, the name of the cake or the bread, okay, or the situation or the pahad, whatever we may call it, jo pahad chadna hai, uska naam aaj pandemic hai, aur pandemic ke chote chote jo versions hai, they're different in every household, very different in every household, you know, some are struggling with other medical illnesses, some are struggling with aging, some are struggling with financial crunch, some are struggling with their own fears, some are struggling with obsessive reactions, some are struggling with too much of work, some are struggling with no work. So its face is different for everybody, and it is going to be different. Eko sat bahu vipra. There are so many faces of the same reality. Okay, now next one, please. Yeah. So what I can appeal to students is, you know, be actively engaged in something. And, you know, a simple mantra I'll tell you, be actively engaged in something means making use of our hands, our paws. Do you know how man has become different from his biological ancestors? You know, by using this front legs. They were once upon a time our front legs, okay, which we slowly got converted into hands and skills. So many skills. I mean, the variety amazes us, okay, right from making, rolling a chapati to making a rocket. All skills humankind has acquired with hands. But the simple scientific fact is, if you want to feel good, you have to make use of hands. So it may be painting, it may be knitting, it may be clearing the floor of your house, it may be anything. But to students, I'll say, you know, at least once a day, you have to sweat, you have to do physical exercise, and you have to do something by using your hands, your legs and your hands. They are like your feet and your paws or palms. They are like switchboards of inner well-being. Okay, they are the switchboards through stresses thrown out. You know, mental stress, aisa hum bolte hai, but you know, we won't go again into philosophical debates. But mind aisa kuch hota nahi hai. Okay, there is no mind. You say, I felt bad in my mind. I was in two minds. Okay, but this is our brain, this is our heart. There is nothing called as mind. It's a linguistic construct which talks about something inner. So where is stress? Stress is saturated in our body. Unless and until we use our hands, we use our legs, it won't go away. Okay. So every day, be engaged in something. Okay. It's not, and that shouldn't be passive as, gadgets, playing on gadgets or watching films. Yes, once in a while with Amit Madam, watching film can be a great source of happiness. Okay, but I'm not talking about creative, but passively, you know, we go on changing the channels or Netflix or OTT, the big Khulja Sim Sim. So, you know, restrict that and more make use of your hands and legs. And sweat at least once a day. Okay, next please. So be open to experience. See, experience is like that small jadoo ki chhadi, okay? It can come anytime, okay? And here we are not talking about great, religious revelations or anything. In the same situation, there can be so many different experiences. As somebody was talking about family times, okay? We can have so much of fun in family with our own brother and sister, or with our grandpa, grandmother, parents, so on. So it can come from any corner. It can come from a good exercise in painting, dancing, and so on and so forth. Okay, so be open to this experience. Be good to others. Okay, that is another very important source of happiness. Next one, please. Yeah, and have awareful thinking. What is awareful thinking? Action with your eyes wide open. That is awareful thinking. The dream of yesterday is hope of today and reality of tomorrow. See, I always say human beings are blessed with a special eye. Okay, I call it Shiva's eye, the third eye. To imagine, to see something different, to see something better. Nurture such dreams. What they will be different for every one of us. But to have a dream is very, very important. To have a hope is very, very important. Okay, so, but at the same time, it should not be like Sheikh Chilli, okay? I'm sure you all must be watching or reading Sheikh Chilli's stories, funny stories. They seem to be funny, but they are, they are again stories, tales of wisdom, okay? So he keeps on watching some dreams, and what is, he loses the contact of reality. That should never happen. So that is why we have to call it as awareful living. Okay, so we are aware of our constraints, we are aware of our situation, and yet we dare to dream. Okay, that has to be the funda to be formed. So, simple take home for all of us, I can say, for my, knowledgeable, wise colleagues, I'm sure it is very, I'm too small a person. And it's just, reminder to our child, the child within us, okay? Be simple and happy in whatever situation we are. Work a lot and learn a lot. Okay, now work a lot. Here I would like to give a lot of emphasis on work out also, especially for younger generation. We shouldn't be eating or sleeping without doing everyday chunk of our workout. So work a lot, other things also. Learn, kitchen courses and whatever you feel like learning, learn it. Okay, so work a lot, learn a lot, be the master of the situation as far as possible. And if you are not also, it's okay. If Viktor Frankl and so many like Viktor Frankl could survive such a difficult situation, I think God has blessed us by being in little better situation. At least we know that it's whatever is happening is a kind of on a very large canvas, worldwide canvas, and it's between nature and one a few species, children of nature. We'll talk about it some other time, but try to be the master of the situation means give correct response to the situation. See, life and beauty are always around us. Don't miss it. Okay. So what is beauty here? Amit Madam, Rina Madam, Shishadri sir, as he just now said, they are having groups of singers and kind of, you know, mehfil, online mehfil. So beauty is within us, around us. We are here essentially talking about beauty, how Plato looks at beauty. Not, you know, a beautiful face or just one painting or just one. No, it's not a thing. It's having that beauty, those glitters in your eyes. Okay, beauty lies in the eyes of beholder, that beauty. And you know, this also help, I would like to connect it with what Gandhiji meant by beauty. Okay, so he always said, what is a person's character depends upon how that person behaves in a smallest situation with the most insignificant surrounding and with most insignificant people. How you can bring grace in that, you know, that defines beauty in human behavior. So we are not talking of only beautiful objects, how we can be beautiful against this backdrop of little unusual situation. Nobody can stop us from being beautiful. Okay, see, let me tell you one of my friends, okay, nothing to boast or nothing to tell having better moral evolution. Yes, of course, somebody has asked, yes. So I'll talk about it.
Professor Dash is from Odisha.
Okay. Yeah. Namaste, sir. Yes. Yeah. So it's this beauty. I was telling you, one of my friends, you know, she lost her 3-year-old baby to cancer. Okay. Now, this girl in past 5 years, she has built one NGO and Tata Memorial Hospital is very near in my locality where she stays. You know, for past 5 years, irrespective of COVID situation, irrespective of any difficulties, every day this girl sponsors food for her NGO. Now she has turned into a venture of NGO. She gives food to minimum 500 people. Okay, she started with 50 because she started with herself cooking, and now it has crossed 1,000 and even more than that, 3,000, because people looking at this cause, you know, they all are supporting her. I say this is beauty. She had every reason to cry, crib, and I don't undermine her sorrow at all, okay? But she responded so beautifully to the situation, okay? Now, the examples are near us, with us. I know the challenges of a few who are here. So, you know, how gracefully you can respond to it. You know, how Viktor Frankl, the day on which he decided that I will survive concentration camp, he receives one, chit in which, you know, he sees two sentences from Old Testament. And, you know, he says, oh, this is the message which I have received from the universe. Okay. And after that, wherever possible, he tries to hold on to that paper and write something about his experience in one word, sometimes in two words, like that. Yeah. So that is what it is. Yes. Yes, yes, it is a challenge to be more perfect as a life, okay? So what best I can do, what most creative I can do in my situation? We need to look or focus on that. So we need to be creative. So it's my appeal to all of us. It's a reminder to me as well, okay? We need to be more creative and enjoy. Enjoy, rather better word would be rejoice. Okay, or be serene and peaceful. Okay, so yes, next please. Yeah, so I would like to, this is for especially again for my student friends, if we can see the video, I'll be very happy if we can listen to this video, Amita madam?
Yeah. You wanted the other one, right?
Yeah, with you know, a small bear and mother bear.
Yeah, this one.
Huh? And I would be closing with that. Thank you very much, Amit madam.
Please. Huh? Yeah, just
and if there are questions, I'll continue.
Just a second, ma'am. Sorry, I forgot to share. Yeah.
It's okay, yeah. Ma'am.
I don't know what is happening. Just a second. I have to select the video. Yeah.
Decision, reason, and emotion. Okay. Yeah. See, decision. Yes. I think Professor Robin.
Okay. He's our FY student.
okay. Yeah, we are happy. Yeah. So, yes. So, what is the relationship between decision, emotion, and reason? See, reason is there is time after students have took. okay, sir. Yeah. So, see, emotions, many a times, you know, we take decisions emotionally. Or sometimes we take decisions only on the basis of rationality, that is thinking. So actually in our life, we need to give equal importance to our emotions as well as to reason. Okay, but you know what emotional intelligence says, that rationally we should be aware of all our emotions and then we should be taking the decision. Let us try to explore one example. Of course, one example. See, for example, if there is a financial crunch, if this is the situation, what is the emotional reaction? Oh, I'm so unlucky. Why this had to happen? Ye nahi hona chahiye tha. What will happen of me? What I'll make the next? Okay, so then you label all these reactions as your very intimate emotions and then say, now come on, Mr. Reason has to intervene over here. And then you say, okay, I understand my emotions, I understand my depression. Now I want to know what can be the response to these my situations. Can any particular activity help me to get rid of this stress as well as to actively overcome this stress? Okay, both the things can happen. Okay, so you decide to actually do something which will fetch you money, to start working in that direction. So this is how emotion and rationality have to work together to make the decisions better. Okay, any one extreme can hamper our life. Okay, so you cannot be dryly taking decisions also all the while. There has to be tadka of emotions to it. Okay, so this is how.
Shall we start sharing?
Yes.
Because it's there. Yeah. Oh, again the same problem. I usually, yeah. Yes. Can it be seen?
Sorry. Yes.
Yes, it's seen, yes, now? Okay.
Ask others.
Yeah.
Ye mat kaho khuda se meri mushkile badi hai. ये मत कहो खुदा से मेरी मुश्किलें बड़ी हैं ये मुश्किलों से कह दो मेरा खुदा बड़ा है आती है आंधियां तो कर उनका खैर मकदम आती है आंधियां
खुदा से मेरी मुश्किलें बड़ी है, ये मुश्किलों से कह दूं मेरा खुदा बड़ा है, मेरा खुदा बड़ा है, मेरा खुदा बड़ा है।
I hope everybody could see that.
Hello? Yes, ma'am. Yes,
yeah,
ma'am.
Yeah, okay, okay. So,
thank you very much for giving me this opportunity.
Okay. No.
Because I love to be with students. That is
yes, good. Of course. And please, students and our dear friends, one of our friends joined from Gadhwal University, Director of Faculty Development Program, Indu Khanduri. Madam was there, and Das sir is there from Odisha, and all our Mumbai University teachers, many of them have joined, and all our dear students. Please ask anything that you have that has stopped you from, you know, exploring yourself. Please ask. This is specially for you all. This lecture is meant for you all. So please, if you have any question, please ask. Sir wanted to ask one question. Wonderful talk, Deepak sir says. This is a very good talk. And yeah, that's very true. And
Vrushali madam also, thank you.
Yes. Vrushali madam is beautiful and profound, she says. Pramod sir says. Das sir from, as I told you, from Odisha, very interesting. And Pragnya says, beautiful, nice video, motivational. And please ask anything that is holding you back. We are exploring, as I told you. You have to explore yourself, who you are. And yeah, it's from this talk, you know, I literally felt that I started loving myself, because there are so many facets to my existence. And let me explore. Though at present teachers are really tied down with a lot of work, but in coming days we will be free, because now we are so used to online teaching that next year is going to be more, explorations and ventures into your own existence. So I think it was quite motivational, and it has cleared all doubts of, maybe not all, but many of the doubts of the students. And thank you, ma'am, so much. I request Reena madam to propose a vote of thanks.
Yes, sure.
Shishadri sir wanted to ask a question.
Yes.
Sir?
Yeah, I wouldn't say it's a question. I thought students will ask questions.
Yeah.
Anyway, first, compliments to Sujitra. I remember 15, 16 years back, you had spoken about me at your seminar, Bioethics.
Yes.
Yes.
And you reminded me that you were my student decades before that. And today I am here as a student sitting before you. And it was wonderful to listen to you, and with that same old smiling face, no change, except perhaps for the specs.
Yeah, yeah.
It was a very well done, you know, your presentation. But one thing that I want you to add to your paper is, every human being lives by hope, whatever the situation. And of course, as a person, I am much older than many of you. And we have seen life, I have seen the first epidemic of the early 60s when we were 7-8 years old. Maybe your parents, some of our parents would have noticed that, yeah. But the fact remains, we never were scared. I told Amit last year during a talk. The thing is, we cannot live in fear.
Yeah.
And you use the word freedom. And that freedom every one of us still has. Hamare mutti mein hamari zindagi hai, aaj bhi hai. Just as we say, you know, I won't go out of the house because it is too hot. Yeah, as simple as, you know, taking an umbrella and walking out. The same is the case during this pandemic. We cannot live in fear. You showed that last video of that bear. You know, I am reminded of one particular law which I, my last year's paper, it is published. The law of wasted efforts. Mm-hmm. An animal doesn't give up till it succeeds. It knows half a dozen attempts and failure. Our scientists will find answers. Our thinkers, philosophers will guide mankind.
Yes.
I have that faith in humanity. We are people like Vivekananda. We are people like Ambedkar. We are people like Abdul Kalam. Ours is a great nation full of great thinkers. We have got the Bhagavad Gita. There is so much we can gain from all the holy texts. All that we know is patience and effort. And your paper highlights that importance of using the freedom positively, hopefully. And I want all these children who are listening, some of them are my students, please, please never give up anything in your effort in your life. You will succeed. And gaate rahiye apne family ke saath, apne doston ke saath, hum hoge kamyab ek din. दो पल की उम्र में एक उम्र चुरानी है.
Yes.
I hope you remember Santosh Anand.
Yes.
भी नहीं तेरी मेरी कहानी है.
Yes.
जियो तो ऐसे जियो के सब तुम्हारा है. मरो तो ऐसे मर के कुछ तुम्हारा नहीं. You will always be happy in your life. Thank you so much for this honor sharing. And Sujitra, wonderful. I want to listen more to you.
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes. We make a booking.
Right.
Thank you so much.
Amit,
thank you, Sujitra.
Yeah, please, Deepak sir.
I wanted to say something.
Please, Deepak bhai, please.
Sujitra ma'am, thank you for this very beautiful talk. And just to add up what Seshadri sir was saying, you know, that we live hope. I just in the morning I saw a message to just on a lighter note, you know, that it was about how we Indians are, that how hopeful we are. That we don't know anything about tomorrow, but you know, we have already started making a pickle for the coming year.
Yes.
Achar bana ke rakha hai, humko ye nahi pata kal kya hoga. So we are hopeful, you know. So that's what is the hope. And as a person, I can say, no, on a lighter note, we Thanekers are really.
Yes.
Patkar madam is also here. So
Patkar. Yeah, Patkar madam is there. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, Vilasini madam. Absolutely. Yes, very true. That is
so much.
Yeah. I am so glad that the fraternity.
All of you.
Yeah. In the philosophy fraternity is there, but we have so many teachers from Jhunjhunwala, from different faculties, and they have participated. So, and they are always there, madam. Deepak sir is also, we are working together in gender equity committee also. So today evening again, we have a rendezvous with Priyamvada madam. So it is going to be great. But thank you for being here. And now I request Reena madam, anybody, anyone who want to share something, please, you can unmute yourself and can talk. And please see that you are there up to the end, because we are going to take a group picture. So please.
Thank you, Suchitra madam, for your wonderful motivational insight. Ma'am, your entire speech, I was reminding Socrates, who said that to find yourself, think for yourself. So I felt really like it's a journey. It's a journey to discover yourself. It's a journey to see where you are. Like, yes, positivity lies within, not outside. So search within yourself, and everything is for you. So that for you, we require to just go inside, and yes, everything is with you. Because if we love ourselves, we will never hurt anyone in any kind of situation. Because see, even though in this pandemic we are come to, we know that people are hurting others by some or other way, that should will not be there. Because if we love, we will love naturally ourselves, because we are just waiting that this storm will go away. But I feel that we need to remain calm. Storm will automatically stop, because our thoughts, as you suggested ma'am, that our thoughts, that you have shown those faces that are nothing but the depiction of our thought on our face. So these thoughts are unguarded thoughts. So if we guard our thoughts, we will never harm others, we will never harm ourselves, and we will live a beautiful, contented life. I really thank, on behalf of HVPS, Ram Niranjan Jhunjhunwala College of Arts, Science and Commerce, extend a sincere vote of thanks to our today's esteemed guest speaker for the day, Dr. Suchitra Naik. It was indeed a great privilege to have you here with us, madam. I know that every listener present here has been benefited and enlightened by your motivational speech. And yes, the last video, what ma'am you showed, it reminded me Sohanlal Trivedi, who said that लहरों से डरकर नौका पार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों की हार नहीं होती. So in this pandemic also, and in our day-to-day life problems which we are facing it out, we will definitely come out of it, because your talk has guided us, help us to train our mind to see something good in everything. That hope which you have given, that hope, yes, my troubles will go away. And that troubles are not forever. It has only a short life. And that short life will really tell us that, yes, we are what we are. I also thank, special thanks to Dr. Amita Valmiki for putting her all sincere efforts to organize this very interesting, informative, and the motivational speech, that too on the online gathering. And ma'am, you have done it like, yes, by your exercise activities which you did with the clapping. It says that, yes, we shall overcome. Not one day, today only we will overcome if we have the positivity with us. I also thank Dr. Indu madam, who has joined us from the Garhwal University, and Dash sir, who has joined us from Odisha. Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot. And my sincere thanks goes to our principal, Dr. Himanshu Davda. Even though sir was not present online, but his wishes are with us. Constant support and encouragement is with us. Thank you, sir. I also thank our director, Dr. Usha Mukundan, for all her support and help. I also thank our secretary, Dr. Rajendra Singh, for providing this digital platform for such kind of intellectual and motivational discourses. And how can I forget? I would like to thank my entire philosophy fraternity who is present right now over here from the different parts of the city, my college colleagues, and my dear, dear student friends who present here, without whom I can, rather than I can call it this talk, it is not a talk. Madam, you have conducted a workshop. For us, we have learned so many, whether we are teacher or we are students, we have learned a lot. So really thank you for this entire wonderful audience which we are having it out. I thank Devi Prasad for all his technical support which he provides us. On the last moment we call him and he is present and he do all the technical assisting for us. Thank you, Devi Prasad Shetty. And once again, I thank you who are join us from the various parts of the country, from the city, my dear, dear students. This talk, I think madam has said that in the beginning, it's only for the students. No, madam, it is for everyone. It really motivated, and you can just see, if when you will see the videos on, of cameras are on of all the students, there will be this the smile on their face. So yes, definitely, madam, we shall overcome today itself. Thank you, Suchitra, madam.
And I thank Reena madam a lot.
Thank for you for your kind words. Very kind.
And all of
generous.
Ma'am, you are such a wonderful being that I can say that your smile only says that. Yes, you're so positive. Your presence gives the positivity.
Yes.
That matters a lot.
Please, all of you, can you switch on your video? Please. Is Robin there? Das sir, namaskar.
Das sir, namaste, das sir.
Namaste, sir. Namaskar.
अरे किसी की नजर ना लगे
पर अपनों की तो कभी नहीं लगती और एक बार मैंने कहा
नमस्ते अभिजय मैडम
रॉबिन प्लीज ओके एवरीबॉडी प्लीज
प्लीज
विजया मैडम थैंक यू वेरी मच
विलासनी मैम प्लीज
यस आई एम देयर
या
वीडियो वीडियो
शाली हेलो यस ऑल ऑफ यू
मनीषा हेलो
दीक्षा पूनम गुड़िया Please, everyone, switch on your videos.
Geeta madam, please.
Please.
Where is Tabasum?
Avinash sir.
I think she must have joined some other this thing, commitment. She had to leave.
Avinash sir, please.
Everybody.
Yes, Swati, Sonal, Neha, Madhiha, Poonam, Aisha. Ma'am, I just told you, now see the smile on the face of each and every student.
Everybody. Vilasini madam.
Yes.
Head of the department of our commerce, commerce subject. And at the same time, the only professor in our college. A very close friend of mine and us, in fact, me and Reena and Department of Philosophy. And madam is always present, not only for philosophy, but all the functions madam is present. And that shows her.
I get to learn a lot from all these speakers.
I always say we are very selfish in matter of
knowledge. Always learners.
And that has to be there. So Robin has clicked pictures. Robin? Yeah, so we conclude the program today. Thank you, everybody. Das sir, everyone. Hindu madam, I will convey my message also to her. Madhiha and everybody. Magmare sir, you haven't switched on, but it's all right. We are thinking of you and clicking the pictures. Thank you, everyone, one and all. We conclude our meeting and see you soon today evening at 6:00. If it is possible for you all to come. And join us for gender equity function. It is on women's rights and women's rights issues in our country, in our society. So from the same college, Madhiha madam, sorry, Madhiha, I don't know, Madhiha is so much, I'm intoxicated by Madhiha. Priyamvada madam is going to speak, vice principal from Joshi Medical. Everybody, namaskar, okay?
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye-bye. Thank you, Sushitra, madam.
Thank you, Sushitra, ma'am.
Have a nice day, all of you. Yeah.
Good to see you.